Good morning, children. Today we are moving to the fifth session of our SS class, isn't it? Yeah, this today is the fifth session of our SS class. First sessions we have discussed about family and matters related with the family. Second chapter we discussed the interdependence, or that means we are in need of others' services. All those things we have discussed. Do you remember? You have to remember those things. Don't forget what we have discussed. All those things you have to keep it in your mind. Anyway, now I'm here with our third topic, that is a home for everyone. What's the name of our topic? A home for everyone. What's the meaning of home? Home is a place where people used to live together. Place where people used to live together. That is called a home. And next, have you ever thought of before or thousands of years ago where our ancestors lived? Ancestors means our forefathers. Before 1000 or 2000 years ago, where did they live? Have you ever thought of that one? Any idea? Yeah, very good. They have lived in caves. Our ancestors lived in caves or under the tree. Under the tree or caves, they took their shelter. Why is it so? Because they were wandering from here and there. They are moving. They are not settled in one place. They are not staying in one particular place. They are moving here and there. So wherever these caves are there, or under the trees, or wherever they get, they take a shelter. But now what happened? Conditions are changed, or situations are changed. We are leading a settled life now. People are, or human beings are, leading a settled life now. So now, in order to live a settled life, what we need? We need a place to live. For that, people started to construct houses. In order to lead a settled life, we need a place. So that man started to construct houses. We all of us are living in houses, isn't it? Isn't it? Yeah, yes, we all of us are living in houses. When we turn into our locality, we can see so many houses. Suppose if you stand in front of your house, you can see your neighbor's house, that side, this side, front side, back side, your neighbor's houses you could see, isn't it? Yeah, yes. Then some houses, or let me ask one question, what all differences you could notice when you observe the house, your houses and your neighbor's houses, what all differences you could find? Yeah, very good. Some houses are big and double storied. Very good. And some houses are small and single storied. So two types of double storied houses and single storied houses. Very good. Double storied, single storied. Then the previous classes and all we have discussed. What type of houses are there in the cities? Can anyone of you say? Do you remember? We have discussed it. Yeah, very good. In cities, we could see multi-storied buildings. Multi-storied buildings. We could see multi-storied buildings. And in some places, we could see bungalows. Multi-storied buildings and bungalows. Some places, in our locality, most of the houses are double-storied. In some places, it is single-storied. In cities, it is multi-storied, and somewhere we could see bungalows also. So, what are the differences between all these two? Is there any differences? The beginning itself, I said, what is the purpose of a house? Purpose of a house is to live together. Live together. That is the aim of the house. That is the aim of the house. Live together. That is the aim of the house. All the family members need to live together and share their things. share the facilities. That is the purpose of the house, isn't it? Yes, the purpose of the house is to live together. The family members wanted to live together. That is the purpose of the house. Okay, is it clear? Why do we need a house? We need a house to live together. Is it clear? Yeah, very good. Now these things, let us discuss this one. Double storied house and single storied house, what may be the difference? Can anyone of you say what may be the difference? Yeah, come on with your answer. Yeah, very good. What is the difference? Double storied houses is a big house with many facilities. Big house with many facilities. Very good, very good. Big house with many facilities. Isn't it? Rooms, maybe more rooms. Number of 5 or 6 or 7 rooms may be there. And many other facilities will be there. But when we compare this double-storied building with the single-storied building, what is happening? Just opposite. Small house with less facilities. Small house with less facilities. Isn't it? Yeah, suppose in double-storied house, ground floor, 2-3 rooms and upstairs, 2-3 rooms. But when we move to single-storied houses, maybe only 3 rooms or 4 rooms. That depends upon the number of members. So that is the difference. Again, multi-storied building that we could see mainly in the city areas. Many families living together. Many families living together. Many families. In a multi-storied building, many families are living together. Now, bungalows, what is happening? It's a one single family is living. One single big house, but only one single family will be living in a bungalow. See, double-storied house is a big house with many facilities. Single-storied house is a small house with less facilities. Multi-storied, many families are living, many families can live together. Bungalows, a single family is living. So now, these are the differences we observe. But can you say something is common with all those things? Something is common. Can you say what is common with all these houses? Something will be common. Can you say? You just guess, you will get the answer. You just think for 1 second, you will get what will be common with all these houses. You will get the answer, sure. Sure. You know, you say, say loudly. Yeah, very good. It is kitchen. All the houses will have a kitchen. Isn't it? Is there any house without a kitchen? Can you imagine? Is there any house without a kitchen? Can you imagine that situation? No. So all the houses, whatever it may be, double storied or single storied or multi-storied or bungalow, whatever it may be, there will be a kitchen in the house. That is a must. Okay, very good. Again, what will be there in what is common? Some of you said something. Some of you said something. Say it loudly, clearly. Yeah, very good. Bedrooms. Bedrooms will be there. Very good. You are getting the idea. Bedrooms will be there. Kitchen is there. Bedrooms are there. Then, next. Ah, very good. That is, toilets will be there. Isn't it? These are common. These things are common factors in every houses. All the houses have these factors. Kitchen will be there. Bedrooms will be there. Toilets will be there. Then only one difference, bedroom. Number of bedrooms may be different. That depends upon the number of persons. Isn't it? Suppose in a house, 10 members are there. Then one or two bedroom is enough for them. No, they need more bedrooms. But only 4 members are there in a house. They need only 2 bedrooms. So that depends upon the number of members. And again, the persons, those who are making this double-storied house or big houses, there are 2 reasons. Can you say? Can you say what are the reasons? Ah, very good. rich man can make a big houses, simple words, isn't it? Rich man, if the owner or if the person is very rich, he can construct a big house with many facilities. Very good. If the person is poor or not having much money, definitely he will construct a small house with limited facilities. That is understood, isn't it? Based on our money, again the number of members, how many members are going to stay in one house, with that the double storied or single storied or multi storied, it is decided. Now let me ask, or let us check, what are the materials used for the construction of houses? What are the materials used for the construction of houses? Materials used for the construction of a house. Materials used for the construction of a house. Can you say? Yeah, your houses are not very big houses. Maybe you house it. What are the materials used for the construction of your houses? Come on. What are the materials used? Ah, very good, very good, very good. What is it? Say loudly. Yeah, very good. It is cement. Again. Again, what else is used there? Bricks. Very good. Again. Cement, bricks. Again. What is it? Ah, very good. Wood. Again. No idea. You will get it, you think? Cement, bricks, wood, then mud. Then what else is there? Glass. Again. Again, no more things. Again, no more things. Concrete. Yeah, these are some of the materials used for the construction of a house. These are some of the materials used for the construction of a house. Now, we have already discussed why do we need a house? Why do we need a house? Tell me, why do we need a house? We have already discussed it. What is it? Why do we need a house? Yeah, very good. We need a house for, or we need a house to live in. We need a house to live in. We need a house to live in. Isn't it? Yes, we need a house to live in. Now, house provides what? House provides shelter. House provides shelter, or the house protect us from what? Say, ah, very good, protect us from rain. Again, what is it? Wind. Again, rain, wind, finished. Summer. Ah, wild animals. Very good. Wild animals. So the house protect us from all those things. Heat, rain, wind, heat, wild animals. A home is a shelter. We all take shelter, isn't it? Suppose heavy rains, if we are playing outside, immediately it is cloudy and raining, what we will do? We will rush to our home. We don't go anywhere, any other place. We will rush to our house. Then if it is so sunshine, we will take shelter inside the houses. Again, wild animals are like, which are the wild animals attacking us? Snakes or other kinds of animals. The house protect us from attack of wild animals, wind, rain and heat. It's a we need a house to live in, and that house protect us from all these kinds of things, isn't it? We need a house to live in, and the purpose of house is to protect us from all these kinds of things. Is it clear? Is it clear? Not clear. Yeah, it is clear, isn't it? Ah, okay. We need a house to live in, and the purpose of the house is to protect us from all these kinds of things like rain, wind, wild animals, and heat. Now we are moving into another thing, that is different houses, different type of houses. Smaller classes you might have large, different type of houses. Smaller classes, do you remember which are the different type of houses? Just try to recollect. Fourth class and all you have lunch. What is it? Nobody is getting the answer. Somewhere I am hearing the answers. Yeah, very good. It is, first one is igloo. This is the picture of an igloo. It is made up of what? Igloo is a house made up of snow. Very good. Igloo is a house made up of snow. This is the picture of an igloo. It is made up of snow. And where it is found? Is it found everywhere? No. It is found only in the area of polar regions or Greenland. Polar regions and Greenland. This igloo is found only in polar regions or Greenland. Okay. Then the people, those who are living in that area, is known as Eskimos. Eskimos. And in that area, what is the speciality of that area? This polar region or Greenland, the available material is only snow. There is no other thing. Whatever material available in Greenland or polar region is ice or snow. So people used to construct a house with that available material, that is snow. You can see the picture of snow. There is only one door. Small house with one single door. And inside the house, they are covering. Inside the house will be covered with the animal's skin, so that house will be warm. Ice, we know, isn't it? How cold it is. So can you imagine a house with the snow? How people are living inside the houses? They are habituated, and moreover, they cover inside the house with the animal's skin, so that the house will be warm. So they were able to live in that house. Okay. Igloo is a house made of snow, found in polar regions and Greenland. The people, those who are living there, is known as Eskimos. And they make the house with the ice and snow. And inside they will cover with the animal's skin to make their body warm. Now, next type of house. Anybody know what is the next type of house? I told you to think what you have learned in fourth class. Nobody is thinking. You have to think, oh, this one we have studied in fourth class. If you think, then automatically answer will come. Yeah, very good. Another answer is tent. Another answer is tent. Another answer is tent. Can you say what type of house is tent, or a tent is made up of what? A tent is made up of animal's skin or canvas. Animal's skin or canvas. A tent is made up of animal's skin or canvas. And this type of houses are mainly found in desert areas. mainly found in desert areas. What's mean by a desert? Desert we have studied. What's mean by desert? A vast area covered with sand and it is extremely hot. Desert is a vast area covered with sand and it is extremely hot. So in that places, these type of houses is possible. Because people may not be, or the desert area, what is the specialty? It is too hot. So people will be everywhere, they cannot construct their houses. They may construct their houses near the place where water is available. So they wanted to carry their houses. They are moving from one place to another place. So that time what is happening? They carry these houses with them. And some other places they will settle, there also they will make these houses. So they wanted to carry these things, especially found it in Saudi Arabia and all the nomadic people or Saudi Arabian people. Nomadic people, wandering people used to make such kind of houses. They are moving from one place to another place, so they wanted to carry these things. Now, another type of house. Another type of house we can say stilt house. Stilt house. What is the speciality of this house? Yeah, you see this picture. It is above the ground. Above the ground, the four pillars are there. And the house is made on top of the pillars. This picture, it is very clear. Isn't it? The picture, it is very clear. The house is not touching on the ground. It is standing on four pillars. The pillars are made on the ground. And these type of houses are found in heavily raining areas. Heavily raining. The area where there is high rain or more rain or always rain. These type of houses will be protecting. That means rainwater won't be entering into their houses. Since it is little bit above from the ground, rainwater won't be entering into their own houses. That is the purpose of these houses. Now again, another type of house. What is another type of house? Let me hear. Some more types of houses are there. First, have you heard of houseboat? Last year you didn't hear? Yeah, if you have not heard, just you listen. Houseboat. I think many of you might have entered into a houseboat. Some of you might have entered. Is there now? Houseboat. Where we can see such a kind of houses? It is a boat in the shape of a boat and uses as a house. It's actually floating on the water. Floating on water. That is called a houseboat. In the shape of a boat, but working as a house, and it is floating on the water. I said some of you might have entered. Means it is commonly found in the backwaters of Kerala. Backwaters of Kerala and Kashmir. Backwaters of Kerala and Kashmir. Kashmir is a tourist place, isn't it? The foreigners used to come to Kashmir. Kashmir is one of the famous tourist place. So there, many lakes are there. So such kinds of boats are there in that houses tourists used to enjoy. Here, backwaters of Kerala, mainly in Alappey district, backwaters are there. Ashtamudi Kail, Vembanad Kail, like that, backwaters are there. So in that backwaters, such kind of boat houses are very common. It's actually for tourists, they used to enjoy. They are moving these houseboats and catching the fishes or all those things they are enjoying. So that is also another type of houses. Then one more type of house is there, yurt. Have you heard this one? Maybe you might have not heard. It's a new word for you. It's a movable house made of bamboo or wood. Movable house made of bamboo and wood. Movable house made of bamboo and wood. What's mean by movable? This is also used by wandering people. I told the tent. Tent is carrying by tent. Again, we can give one more example. Circus and all. Have you seen circus? The people, those who are doing different kinds of circus, they move from here to there. And one place, they will settle there for 1 week or 2 week or 1 month. They will make a big tent there. That also is okay. But here, this yurt or movable house made out of bamboo or wood is used by these wandering people. Wandering means not settling in one place, moving from one place to another place. This is found in Central Asia mainly. People are moving from here to here and there. So they are carrying the houses also with them, or the materials also with them. Now, these are the different types of houses. What is this picture? This is the picture of a igloo made out of what? Made out of snow and ice. Where it is found? Come on. Where it is found? Yeah, it is in polar regions or Greenland. And the people, those who are living there, is called Eskimos. Now, next one, what we have discussed, what type of house is the another one? Another one we have discussed, tent. It's a house made out of canvas or house made out of canvas. Then, who uses? The people, those who move from one place to another, uses this one. Just now I said one example, tent, very common for you, circus. Or this type of people are using such a kind of tent. Again, what is this picture? This is houseboat, mainly found in backwaters and Kashmir. Tourists are using. Next one is tilt house, found in highly raining areas. Is it clear? Isn't it clear? Any doubt? Clear now? Yeah, yes, okay, it's very clear. And now, another one more question. Now you understood what we have discussed, different type of houses. So you have to give me one answer. I'm going to ask one question, you have to give me the answer. Igloo houses, is it suited for desert? Igloo houses, okay. Is it suited for desert? That's what my question. You just think about, then you will get the answer. Is it igloo houses suited for the desert? I told the desert meaning what type of place is a desert, I said. What is igloo, I said. Then you have to connect igloo and desert. Then you will get the answer. Somebody got, I think? Yeah, come on. Don't worry about the answer is wrong or not. I'm not going to do anything. I want to get ideas from you. Come on. Yeah, very good, very good, very good, very good. Give one clap. Ah, yes, it is. And desert is very hot. Then what will happen to the ice or snow? That will be melted. Melted means ice or snow will be changed into water. Very good. Now another question. Someone else have to tell me the answer. Not the same person. Someone else have to give me the answer. Okay. Tent house is not possible in highly raining areas. Tent is not possible in highly raining areas. Why? Yeah. Don't sit and smile. Give me the answer. See, previous answer, came from there. So that next answer has to come from here. First, come on. I already said, if the answer is wrong, nothing is going to happen. Just I want to know how far you catch. Highly raining areas. Not getting any idea? Okay, don't worry, I will tell you. Highly raining areas. Then tend means what it is made up of? It is made up of animal's skin and canvas. Isn't it? Tent is made up of animal's skin and canvas. So if it rains every day very heavily, these things will be spoiled or these things will be get wet. So these things will be spoiled. That is the reason. Every day if it rains, the animal's skin or those canvases will be spoiled. That is the reason. Now what is the next step? You have to read the textbook, learn the difficult words, spelling and meaning, and try to complete S1 and S2 and some practice questions from page number, which page number? Page number 18, isn't it? S1 and S2 and practice questions from page number 18, 192. 192. Okay, practice questions 192. That you have to write it in your notebook. So with this, we are going to conclude or bind up our today's lesson.